is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to you out of a quick video. I wanted to let you guys know I got some new merchandise available, not just t-shirt anymore. I got different type of t-shirt, different type of shirts and logos that you can purchase on my spread shirt, and also hoodies now. We have expanded and added more to the channel and more merchandise for the brand. Thanks for supporting. It will be in the description and the links will be in the comment section below. Thanks for helping me and supporting the movement. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis. I'm going to check out the video. What is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to y'all with some quick analysis again. Harrison Barrison Barnes has come back to the Kings for a four-year $85 million deal. We already knew that this was going to happen as they came close to agreeing. He took a little less money. He still got his 4 years. He stayed with the Kings. They traded for him. They wanted him to be a part of this team. He improved his three-point shooting off the ball. He still can handle and score the ball in isolation. He does fit with Buddy Hield and De'Aaron Fox because they do like to get up and down the court. They do need somebody that can create their own shot from time to time, somebody that can give into close games when it's necessary. And they do have a guy that wants to stay there. At the end of the day, he proved that by signing this extension. So the trade was worth it. You get Harrison Barnes. You didn't make the playoffs, but you got him to commit for the 4 years. And they feel like that's their guy for that three position. But they also gave some reinsurance just in case he gets injured or they need somebody else to even play small ball. They ended up picking Trevor Ariza up for 2 years, $25 million. 2 years, $25 million. Trevor Ariza took less money than he did last year. He didn't have the best year last year, but we still know that he's a veteran that's going to go out there and compete. He does fit perfectly with their young core as a guy that doesn't need the ball to be effective. He can play off the ball for them, knock down threes, get out in transition, and also be a leader for them in that young locker room. Dewayne Dedmon also agreed to a three-year deal for $40 million. He's a guy that's a hard-nosed guy. He is a perfect guy with Trevor Ariza to bring toughness to this team. He also can give you that floor spacing ability if you do need that, which they do because you want to have room for De'Aaron Fox to be able to play in the pick and roll, get to the paint, and you do want to have guys that can space out the floor so he can make his job easier getting to that floater, that pull-up, or even if you go under the screen, he can knock down that three, which he showed that he can do this season. But I love Dewayne Dedmon. I feel like he was one of the steals the last couple years for the contracts that he was on. He finally got a big payday for all the hard work he put in and for evolving his game. He's a solid rebounder. He's a solid rim protector. And he is worth the money that they paid him because they might lose Willie Cauley-Stein for nothing. And if that really is the case, at least they got somebody that can come in there and shore up that that center position other than Giles and the other bigs that they have. They got a veteran that played on winning teams and teams that have made it to the playoffs. And he even played with younger players with the Hawks. So he already knows kind of how the locker room going to be and what he really needs to bring to the table. Also, you got to think about it. You get Harrison, a guy that has won a title, has played in championship games multiple times, has lost titles, won titles, and really has been through it all, even being one of the best high school players, playing on a loaded team in college, and he has seen it all. So this is the right way to go. You want to go to a playoff mode. You don't want to be a team in a lottery. You don't want to be a team in a lottery no more. You want to be a legitimate team in the West. Only problem with these moves is that these moves don't really push them into a lock. I think it's a lot of moves that have been made and moves to still be made. I still can't lock the Kings into a playoff spot. I like their coach. I like their two backcourt players. I like what they're doing, but I still can't guarantee that they're going to be a guaranteed playoff team. And we really got to see if Buddy Hield and De'Aaron Fox going to take that next level to become all-star caliber players. They played close to it. They was on the star level. Can they get to that all-star level? Because they're going to need somebody that can really thrust them to another level. These pickups make them deeper, make them better, more ready, but it doesn't push them over the top. And it might be another deal that they're trying to make. It might be the development of Fox and Buddy Hield, or maybe De'Aaron Fox takes his game to another level. Wherever it may be, they're not there yet, but this is going in the right direction.
Only problem, like I told y'all before, is when you sign in these type of deals, it does lock you up to a point where if you don't make the playoffs, you might not be able to become better than you are unless you trade some of your young assets to get somebody else that can literally take you over the top. So when you get Dedmon, you get Ariza, you get Barnes on these type of deals, it locks you into this roster, and it takes away a lot of your flexibility to get better without adding draft picks or even, like I said, young talent to get that player that you really do want or get that other superstar player or even an all-star player to come to this team, because the cap space is now gone and now you only really have what you have on your roster and you locked into that roster. And if they don't make it to the playoffs, all these acquisitions will be pointless because you just don't want a competitive team. You want a team that can really compete. And I don't feel like they're at this level even with these pickups. And they pretty much proved it when they got Harrison Barnes and it was basically the ninth seed and they still weren't able to make it to the playoffs in those last month and a half. So it shows you that they is a little away from where they really want to be. But at the same time, they is in a good spot, in my personal opinion. So let me know what you guys think. Do you think Dedmon was a good deal? Do you think Barnes was a good deal? Do you think they should even try to get Trevor Ariza? Or do you think that they got the right positions filled, they got the right type of talent around them, and they will be able to make it to the playoffs? If you disagree with me, that's fine. Let me know why. If you agree with me, like the video and comment and let me know why. And at the end of the day, I'm on to the next video. I got a lot more to pump out for you guys, and I'm having fun doing it. Check out my Facebook page, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Check out my website, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Thanks for everybody that likes on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes the videos. Thanks for everybody that comments. I like the activity that you guys have shown. I answer comments that make sense, if that makes sense. And also, at the end of the day, if you like this video, check out my older videos on my channel. I have many playlists. I break down rookies. I break down players. I break down summer league. I do cover the draft, and I got a mock draft up already. Not only that, I do podcasts, and I also talk about the game of basketball, whether it comes to summer league, free agency, trade deadline, buyouts, and also I cover top 10 discussions and stuff like that. So you like this type of video, you like the NBA, check out my older videos and my playlists. I enjoy making these videos. You guys enjoy watching. I'm going.